In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Louise died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May Louise now share with Christ eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, who alone are able to give life after death, free your servant Louise from all sins, that Louise, who believed in the resurrection of your Christ, may, when the day of resurrection comes, be united with you in glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Kindly be seated for the readings. May I now invite Mary Ann to come forward for the first reading.
Ecclesiastes. A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. Thanks be to the word of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. We are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. We walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Father, my disciples are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me, that they may see my glory that you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world also does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I made known to them your name, and I will make it known that the love with which you loved me may be in them, and I in them. The Gospel of the Lord. Kindly be seated. Dear friends, as guests of Louise's immediate family, your role today and for the days ahead is to bring consolation and comfort to Louise's family by your presence at their side and by your retelling of favorite stories, so that you might lift up Louise's family as if on eagle's wings. As believers, we frequently look to the New Testament book of Revelation. There we find this consoling reassurance and promise, Blessed are those who have died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labors, for their good deeds go with them. Although today Jamie will speak after Holy Communion about Louise's good deeds, each of us here today carries within our hearts our own particular list of Louise's good deeds. Today we also declare that there are doubtless many good deeds of Louise's that only God recalls this morning. Friends, we have addressed God in prayer today as the one who is alone able to give life after death. As heirs to the Christian biblical tradition, we believe that God, the Almighty Father, has already decisively displayed this power to give life after death by raising Jesus, his only begotten Son, from the dead on the third day, Easter Day. The sacrament of baptism plunges us all into the death of Jesus and brings us up out of the waters as sharers in the new risen life of Jesus. Dear friends, we spend our days on earth, our allotted time, doing our best to live in this newness of risen life with Jesus and the great company of his followers and friends. In today's prayers over the offerings of bread and wine, we will make this prayer request of God the Father, that Louise, who did not doubt your son Jesus to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge. Dear friends, may these words, the songs, and the prayers of the funeral ritual bring you some measure of strength and consolation today and for the days ahead. Kindly stand for the prayers of the faithful. God, the Almighty Father, raised Jesus Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. To each petition, please reply, Lord, hear our prayer. For Louise, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that Louise may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord. For Louise, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that Louise may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord. For our deceased relatives, neighbors, and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of Louise, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord Jesus, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord. For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in the joy and peace of God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Kindly be seated. I may stand. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Louise, we beseech your mercy that Louise, who did not doubt your son Jesus to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For Jesus is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Louise, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that Louise, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with our spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Friends, as you come forward for Holy Communion, please hold your hand out flat to receive Holy Communion. Thank you for your cooperation.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Louise, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of happiness, light, and peace through Christ our Lord. Kindly be seated for Jamie's words of remembrance.
For those of you that I haven't met, my name is Jamie, and I am Louise's youngest child. My mother was born in Southbridge in 1944, the oldest of four children, with three younger brothers to follow. Although Southbridge's life was not always easy, she had a very close and unbreakable bond with her brothers, Paul, David, and Dennis. She had a very special relationship with her maternal grandmother, and some of her favorite memories from her childhood were when she spent time with Rose and slept over her grandmother's house in the summer. My siblings and I have heard countless stories of my mom and her brothers getting into mischief, causing trouble, and having lots of fun. There was the time that she borrowed the priest's car to run to the store with a girlfriend, and on the way back home, the brakes failed, and she almost ran over her friend's mom, and then drove right into the neighbor's porch stilts, knocking the porch off the house. Oops. Her brothers were always very protective of her, like that time they found her fiance smooching another girl in the car. They broke that guy's arm and flipped his car over. My mother was also very protective of her three little brothers. When they were very young, there was a boy down the street that was picking on one of her brothers. She stormed right over there and started a fight with him. She beat him up all the way down the stairs. He lived on the third floor. Needless to say, that boy never picked on her brothers again. My parents and my aunts and uncles and even my extended Eagle Drive family spent a lot of time making memories out on Webster Lake. We were so proud growing up to know the real name of Webster Lake. The cousins were very close growing up and especially loved our annual Ciccarelli family Christmas party traditions. My mom loved her nieces and nephews dearly. She was also very close to my Aunt Kathy, who she felt was more like a sister than an in-law. My mom met my dad when he owned a roller skating rink in the area. They hit it off and started dating and eventually got married. They went on to have four children, Lisa, Carrie, Sean, and me. My dad had a daughter, Danielle, from a previous marriage, and my mother always considered Danny to be her bonus daughter, even after she kept finding bread stuffed in her jewelry box. My family moved to Franklin, Eagle Drive, in the late 70s. We were very blessed to have the neighborhood we did. Our neighbors have always been our family through the best and worst of it all. And while my parents did divorce after 14 years of marriage, they were luckily able to maintain a respectful and sometimes even close relationship. My mom would still call my dad whenever there was big news or gossip to share. On Eagle Drive, we had cookouts every weekend in the summer, sometimes several times a week. Many times, those cookouts turned into sleepovers for us kids. If it wasn't a cookout or a sleepover night, everyone in the neighborhood could hear my mom yelling out to us in the dark after she had already called us in nicely the first time, "Get in here or I'll break your legs." The Eagle Drive years were the best. We were truly in the right place at the right time. Marianne, the DeMels, the Marshes, the Ludinskys, the Mastersons, our forever family. My mother was blessed with nine grandchildren and one great-granddaughter, as well as one sweet boy that was soon to be her step-grandson. Anytime you spoke to my mom, she had funny stories to share about her grandchildren. She loved to text cute pictures of them to her friends. She even loved telling me stories about Brody Crosby and Macy, even if I was the one that originally told her the story. She was so proud of the mother that Morgan is, and loved getting her hair cut by Ashley. She loved her phone chats with Megan and was proud that she's been working so hard these days. She was proud of the hard work Haley's doing to become a nurse. She loved when the boys, Derek and Ryan, would come to visit or spend the holidays with us. She loved to talk about how tall and handsome they are. She was head over heels for baby Evie and loved to comment on how happy a baby she is and how she loves to eat. My mother absolutely loved being a Grammy, or Bobby, as some have called her. And she was so very loved in return, so much so that three of the girls have Louise as their middle name. My mom was never really a baker, but she so enjoyed giving snacks and treats to all her kids and grandkids. She was never without Dunkin' Donuts coffee, Oreos, Cape Cod potato chips, M&Ms, or some new cracker or chip snack. And when she asked you if you wanted to try one, you better say yes or have a really good reason why you couldn't possibly have one. Even then, you were definitely going to be on the receiving end of a guilt trip. If there is one lesson I've learned well, when a mom or grandmother wants you to try something, just do it. My mother didn't really eat conventional meals often. She liked to graze. A small meal here, some snacks there, and always, even when she was a young girl, she loved to eat pasta in the middle of the night. Well, really any time, but especially in the middle of the night. My mom worked for three very special women through Gynecology Partners PC for over 20 years. She loved her job and was very proud of it, and she was great at it. My mother was never the type of person to stick to the job description that she was given. If she saw something needed to be done, she took care of it. She always stayed late and always went the extra mile. She had some great coworkers over the years, but always remained very close with her good friend Debbie. She retired from Gynecology Partners PC in 2012 to stay home and nanny my kids. She was so excited for the opportunity to stay home with my babies. Again, she was just the best Grammy. After selling our family home on Eagle Drive in 2010, my mom moved to Apple Tree Hill Condominiums in Hopkinton, where she eventually became the Condo Association President. She was great at that role too, and most everyone liked her. Her least favorite part of that job was having to call each of the tenants on the morning of a snowstorm and walk them through exactly how to navigate moving their cars for the plows. That drove her crazy. She would watch the weather all winter, and if the forecast called for snow, we would all get phone calls in preparation of how annoyed she was going to be to have these conversations with these people. While living in Hopkinton, my mom met some of her very best friends. My mom had a zest for life, and that was never more apparent than when she was doing her famous chair dance to Blurred Lines over at the Dynasty in Hopkinton with her girlfriends. Sue, Lucy, Shannon, and the whole gang, you gave my mom the fun single years that everyone should have. She was never as happy as when she was stomping around Hopkinton having fun with these friends. And oh, the stories these ladies could tell. Wheezy, as she was fondly known by so many, was a fantastic and unexpected sports mom. When I was growing up, she never missed any of my practices. Even the summer softball doubleheaders during a heat wave, she and my Auntie Nancy even drove me and Holly to Montreal one summer to play in a tournament there. And Andy was there too. She loved to watch the Patriots, and she loved to complain about them when they didn't win. If the Patriots were playing that Sunday, whether she was going out or staying in, she would be having many apps, and 100% she'd be having wine. My mom loved to spend time with her children and grandchildren. She loved spending Saturdays with Lisa, going to Big Y, getting B12 shots together, running around doing little errands. Even the most boring things were fun when you were with my mom. She loved when Lisa or Carrie would sleep over and watch Golden Girls and other favorites. When my sisters would sleep over, I could hear them up laughing and having fun until the early morning hours, especially you, Carrie. When I would have to run errands on the weekends, I would often text her to say, "Hey, I'm running to Target, do you want to come?" And her response was always, "Just give me time to comb my hair and put my shoes on." My mom's dog, Bailey, was also the light of her life. All our family dogs have always been Cocker Spaniels, and they've always been a little bit crazy. My mom and Bailey had such a special bond. Wherever my mom was, there was Bailey. When my mom would go to the backyard to sit and watch Bailey run around and play, Bailey would just come over and sit on top of her lap for the whole time. It was not unusual for me to receive multiple pictures of Bailey in a day or a week, or multiple selfies of my mom with Bailey. My mother had so many wonderful traits and also some very endearing quirks. For one, she would always say the word say when laughing really hard. I never understood it. She didn't know she did it, but it was hysterical. She called the place you go to when you see the movies the theater. Corduroy pants, she called those corduroys. Best of all, my mom had the loudest sneeze of all time. I too have a loud sneeze, but I've got nothing on Wheezy. One time we were at Craigville Beach, just hanging around, enjoying our time like always. All of a sudden, this lovely lady goes strolling past us, not a care in the world. Out of nowhere, Wheezy lets go of one of the most epic sneezes I've ever heard in my life. This poor woman screamed so loud, I thought she was going to have a heart attack on the beach. She needed several minutes to recover and sat in our chair to gain her composure. I never stopped teasing my mom about that beach sneeze. Unfortunately, my brother Sean passed away unexpectedly at the age of 41, the same weekend that my mother was supposed to move into our home with us. My brother's passing was something that my mother could just never and would never get over. She loved him so dearly and missed him every single day. This, of course, made the transition to moving to my house much harder. I do think that getting to see my kids grow up and spend so much time with them has made it bearable for her. She loved spending time with Brody and Crosby and Macy. She loved watching game shows with them or Disney movies. She always enjoyed movies with animals that talked for some reason. And she at least pretended to love playing countless hours of Zingo and Sneaky Snacky Squirrel and Pretty Pretty Princess when Macy would share the crown, which was not always. She referred to herself as the cellar dweller, which drove me crazy because she lived in our basement. But of course, that made her just think it was all that much funnier. She especially enjoyed coming upstairs at the worst possible times to give my kids treats and desserts and snacks. What I wouldn't do to have that happen just one more time. My mom has had many son-in-laws in her life, or people that she considered to be like a son-in-law. And from day one, she had a very special close bond with my husband, Marty. They were like two little buddies. He taught her some very inappropriate phrases, which she loved to bring up as often as possible. And they just loved each other. And I think once she moved in, their bond got even closer because anytime I would leave, apparently she would come up and the two of them would gossip about me. And she loved him so much. This past summer, my mom's oldest brother, Paul, died suddenly after a short battle with COVID. This was a major heartache for my mom. As I mentioned, she was very close to her brothers. Not a day has gone by that she hasn't thought of or missed her brother, Paul. My mother was so full of love. She treated everyone like family. She loved to be silly and to make people laugh. And if you could make her laugh, man, did that make you feel good. I loved making my mom laugh. She'd flash that big smile and her whole face would light up. Growing up, we always said, I love you more to each other over and over. Now that I'm an adult, my mom texted me almost every single day to tell me just how much she loved me. And on several occasions, she would thank me for how much I loved her or ask me to never stop loving her as much as I do. This gives me some peace. My mom didn't have the easiest childhood or the easiest life, but for as long as I can remember, I had vowed to ensure that my mom would not have to worry or struggle, and that she would feel true love always. And those messages to me showed me that no matter what, she knew she was loved oh so dearly. I don't know how I will go on through this life without my mother, without the hugs that feel like home,
without her smell that brings me back to my childhood. She was my very best friend and the person I always relied on. And in these later years, we relied on each other. It's impossible to sum up the life my mother lived and the bond we shared and the love she had for everyone here in one short eulogy. So I will just say to you, Mom, I hope that you are at peace. I hope that you are reunited with Sean and Uncle Paul. Watch over us always, especially my babies. And my beautiful mother, I'll say what you have always said to us. All my love until forever ends.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Louise, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Louise again and enjoy her love and friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow today, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. To you, O Lord, we commend Louise in the sight of the world. She is now dead, but in your sight may she live forever. In your goodness, grant her your everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In trust, hope, and peace, let us take Louise to her place of rest.